The other thing you need is exactly the reverse. And that is the belief that you are very likely to get the wrong end of the stick. And that you get the wrong end of the stick not just at the first time of asking, but at the second, third, and indeed the first half dozen times of asking. That you won't just miss the point of a Thomas Mann novella the first time you read it, but probably the second and third time. In other words, that you have to have an extremely self-critical view, that you have to think that mastery is the name of the game, and that mastery is going to require a great deal of practice, a great deal of trial and error, and learning from painful experience. Socrates was very surprised when the Oracle at Delphi said that he was the wisest man in Athens. He was surprised because he thought he knew nothing. He then decided that the Oracle was right. Everybody else thought they knew all sorts of things, which they didn't. He, at least, knew that he knew nothing. I must say, it's easy to see why the Athenians became so irritated by Socrates. But the point is that Socrates' skepticism was not disabling. It made him examine everything. The examined life is not worth leading, he said, which I always thought was a great deal too fierce and a great deal unkind to people who seem to be leading perfectly happy and cheerful lives without a great deal of self-examination. The better proposition, and the one I wish to offer now, is not that the unexamined life isn't worth living, but rather that for anyone with the requisite curiosity and the requisite energy, the examined life can be a great adventure. So why does this achieve intellectual liberation? Three crucial things. The first is it enables one to break with intellectual habits. A lot of the time at school, and no doubt immediately after, we are acquiring habits and we need them. Unless we can rely on habit for a lot of life, we can't get on with life at all. But intellectual habits can always lead one astray. And so the first kind of liberation that a liberal education can give one is simply to get one out of ingrained habits. Second is it teaches us to think for ourselves, to become masters of our own minds, mistresses of our own intelligence. And the third thing is it liberates one from the kind of anxiety that people suffer when they fear that if they change their mind about something, it will become completely disabling. And if they give up some cherished conviction, this is going to be the end of everything. Knowing that it isn't, knowing that it's the beginnings of finding out something new, that it's the beginning of an adventure which may get started during years in higher education, but which can, with reasonable luck, go on for 50 or 60 years thereafter. That is one of the great payoffs from liberal education.